this.
Okay.
Okay, you know like how you salsa dance?
Yeah. Okay.
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 So when you are power walking, you're doing this movement right here. Right? So I don't eat any type of red meat. I don't. The only part of the chicken I eat is the chicken breast. And I eat a lot of fish. Lots of vegetables. Lots of water. No juice. No sugar. No cake. No nothing like that. No white bread. You know I'm Jamaican. No dumpling.
Oh wow.
No, no rice or peas.
Damn. So you kind of like stay away from the complex carbs? Why?
That is important.
And y'all see it? Get your body looking right and tight in those fits. You feel me? It don't matter what age.
Go pump. Go pump. Yeah.
Yo. What is up, guys? We are back at it again, man. And I'm here with the beautiful goddess, Blonde Locks, man. If you guys watched the old video, she was killing me, man, with the workouts. You know what I mean?
Blonde Locks. Blonde without the E, Locks without the K.
Yes, are you kidding me? You guys better go follow her. Subscribe to her YouTube channel, follow her on TikTok and Instagram. And today, she's gonna be showing me, cause yo, she is one of like the healthiest women at her age. Like, look at this.
57.
Look at the six. Look at the packs. I can see packs through the. Like, how is that possible? Her body is so right at what age?
57.
50.
Man, 58 is knocking on my door.
Yo, that's hard to believe. And she's gonna show us like some routine she does to keep herself in shape, and you can also do it too. You know, so keep watching, guys. So what's the first thing?
I do a lot of power walk.
Mm-hmm.
Now there's a technique to this. It's not just going out there and walking. There's a technique. The first thing you want to do is make sure you engage your core. All right, a lot of people don't engage their core. And when you don't engage your core, when you walk, you're walking slumped like this. If you see a lot of people when they walk like this. That's because they're not engaging the core.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the first thing, engage your core. Second thing, you wanna, and by keep engaging your core, you're keeping yourself upright, you breathe better.
Mm-hmm.
Second thing, your arm above your hip bone.
Okay.
And when you walk, you're going like this. Third thing is your hips. You're going like this.
Okay.
Okay, you know like how you salsa dance?
Yeah. Okay.
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 So when you are power walking, you're doing this movement right here. Alright?
Alright.
Fourth thing, your legs. It's not coming off, it's not lifting up. You're keeping your legs straight, heel on the ground. So you're incorporating everything at one time. So this is it right here. So the first thing, just to get on there, then you go fast.
Okay.
And that's it. It's real
so
simple.
So, how many rounds of that do you, how many rounds of that?
Well, when I first started, I are you doing like the walking race with that? So when you're doing it, your arms are gonna be here, not across the body. It takes it away, it makes you work harder doing the walk. So
right.
When you're walking, it's.
Okay.
And use the arm is. Wind the butt.
Straight up and down.
Straight up and down.
See? Look at it. Talking about.
Look at it. Pocket. Look at it. Pocket. Wind the butt. Okay? But pump the arms. It'll make you move. Don't go force.
That's right.
Nice.
You go faster when your arm is
right.
Like
now you
this.
Got it. That's it.
Okay?
Okay.
I'm open to corrections.
Yeah, that's it. That's it.
That's what's up.
So somebody corrects me and I take it.
Love it.
Okay.
So okay. what is this called?
Huh?
What is it called?
Oh, this is power walking.
Power walking. Hmm.
Some people
call it speed walking, but it's power because you're putting, it's literally working your entire body. When you do this, what are you doing? You're working your arms,
yeah.
Your shoulders, your back is engaged, your chest is engaged, your abs engage, your hips are engaged, your quads, everything, even your shin, everything is engaged.
Right. Do it one more time. And how many laps or like how many?
As a beginner,
It's
good to just take it slow. Allow your body to speak to you. That's my philosophy. Allow your body to speak to you. Because a lot of people overdo it and then they're in pain. You could do it from here down to the end and back.
Okay.
The more advanced you get, you just do one lap, then you go two laps, and then you just increase it.
Okay.
How I do it by timing. So if I do a mile a day, right? And I time myself. If it take me a half hour the first day, the next day, I'm doing it 20 minutes. Then I do 15 minutes to complete that mile.
Okay. Nice.
All right, so I'm gonna do it one more time.
Yeah.
Okay, so remember this, then this.
That is nice. It was hard to keep up. That's dope.
Try.
Yeah, let me try. I guess.
I'll give it a try, guys.
Okay, this is what she was doing. He was doing this. Exactly like what she was talking about. Okay? So just pretend that you're saltine.
Okay.
Now, guys don't necessarily have to move their hips. I see a lot of guys, they just do it.
Oh, okay.
But for women, it comes natural for us to do this. And it engages your obliques.
That makes sense. And it gives you those nice hips too.
Exactly.
Okay. Okay, nice. What's the second thing you do?
Oh, man. Let me tell you something. The first thing is your eating.
Of course. Okay.
You have to be consistent with your eating. So I don't eat any type of red meat. The only part of the chicken I eat is the chicken breast. And I eat a lot of fish. Lots of vegetables. Lots of water. No juice, no sugar, no cake, no nothing like that. No white bread. You know, I'm Jamaican. No dumpling.
Oh, wow.
No rice or peas.
Damn. So you kind of like stay away from the complex carbs? Why?
That is important.
Why?
Why? Listen, you see this right here? This is 57 years.
Okay.
When I go to the doctor, my numbers are good. I don't have high blood pressure. I don't have all those other stuff that people complain about. I don't have anything like that. So I am very, very conscious. As you reach over 40, you have to be more and more conscious because our bodies slow down naturally with age. So you have to be more cognizant of what you put in. If you put in junk in your body, of course, what are you gonna excrete but junk?
Yes.
So you just have to be very, very careful with that.
That makes sense. That makes sense.
And then the second thing is sleep.
Yeah. Peace, God. Thank you, bro. Thank you, brother. Thank you. Thank you, bro.
I love it. You're famous.
Hey, trying to be famous out here.
You need at least 7 or more hours of sleep per night. I don't know about you guys, but over 40, over 50, I'm in bed by 9 o'clock.
That makes sense.
No computer after 9, no cell phone after 9, no TV after 9, because what happened? Those bright things, that it's communicating to your brain is overactive, and it's hard for you to go to sleep. So that's why they say to read a book, or listen to some music, but you need at least minimum of seven hours sleep.
Sheesh. That makes sense, and you know, how would you say life is for you? Like, you know, because I feel like, this is just my personal feelings. I feel like, you know, when your stress level is low as far as like your environment, the people you have around you, you know, if you have a man that loves you, if you have a nice family, that also plays a part, you know what I mean? But if you have like people that are stressing you out, that can also play a part.
You know, what you meditate on is what your body regenerate. So if you focus on the negative all the time, then guess what? Your whole countenance reflects negativity. But no matter what's going on around you, I know I sound, you know, like a Pollyanna. I'm not. But I mean, I have stress like everybody else. You know, there was a time when I'm getting married, by the way.
Oh, congrats. That's what's up. Damn, I would have thought you was taken already. You know, I thought you was married already.
I've married, divorced,
single
for a few years. I decided to just work on myself, work on my mentality, work on me. And after the healing process started, then guess what? I attracted what was inside of me.
That makes sense. I'm going to ask you some good questions now.
Go ahead.
You know? What values? Oh, sorry. Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Wow. First, I'm gonna ask. What are the values, man? Do you feel like a man has to bring into a relationship? You know.
The first thing I look for is consistency in his lifestyle.
Because
you know, if a man is not consistent, in the things that he does outside of me, he's not going to be consistent with what he does with you, right? I look for, he has to be able to put 2 sentences together.
Yeah, that makes sense.
But I look for honesty. I look for creativity in what he does for me, you know? It's not all about what he has, because, I mean, at this stage, I should hope by, damn, you should have something. If you're still working, you know, just to accomplish something at age 60, damn.
Yeah, it's a struggle out here. That'll be crazy. Now, what values do you feel like you bring into your relationship? If you don't mind me asking.
I bring a whole lot.
Okay, blonde locks.
I bring a whole lot to the table.
Shit, we can see that already.
Hello.
Hello.
You want to know something? This can fade.
Yeah.
Okay? God forbid I could get sick, I'll get an accident, whatever it is, all that can go. I thank God that he has his hands on me.
Mm-hmm.
But the one thing is, I'm true to my word. I'm a woman of my word.
Mm-hmm.
If I say I'm going to do something, I'm going to do it. I stick to my word.
Nice.
I am 100%. At my age, I don't feel I have to lie about anything.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like, you don't like it, or what you gonna do?
Yeah.
Hit me? Yeah, all right.
Yeah, that makes sense.
You know,
that
but,
makes sense.
Yeah, I'm a woman of word. I'm honest. You can count on me. Just the basics that you're taught as a kid, you bring it to the table as an adult. Hopefully you didn't forget about it.
Yeah.
You know, I'm a woman of God. I'm a woman of faith. You know what I mean? And that is very, very important to me. And if he's not a woman of, if he's not a man of faith, we can't rock.
That makes sense. That makes sense. This is beautiful. This is beautiful. I'm congratulations, you know, and that just shows you guys she's still young, getting married at the age of 57. That's the age I want to get married.
Really?
Like 60, 50s. Yeah, because
why? Because you are setting your ways at
yeah,
60.
I feel like
to break you.
Because you know, it's just me personally. I just haven't really believed in marriage.
Wow.
You know, I believe in having kids and we could live together, you know. And then if we were able to have a kid that was a 20-year-old and, you know, we had all of that, then we can get married. Because it's like, we're still together. We've established that, then we could get married. If not, you know, I feel like at that age, you really find your soulmate. I don't know what it is.
But you know something? A lot of people think that love can sustain a marriage. And it really don't. The biggest business deal that two people can make is marriage. That's my philosophy.
Yeah.
Don't judge me. Don't.
Yeah.
I don't want to hear the comments. But the biggest business deal that two people can make is when they come together in marriage. If you have a partner in business, right?
Is
not a form of marriage?
That's a fact. You have a contract, yeah.
That's a form of marriage.
And that was my personal belief. Like, marriage is a business. It's not, it doesn't have anything to do with love. But we can do it with love, you know what I mean? But it doesn't mean I love you. So, like, I feel like the love has to be first. That's why I said I'd rather build the house. Or not build the house, have a house, have kids. And, you know, we're still together. And that makes it more official. Or if not, even if we're not still together, like, let's say things didn't work and I found somebody else, I just feel like, now I know who I want to be with because I've went through trials and errors. Then I can marry. I don't know.
I think that, like, that's like a commitment thing.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you're just there with somebody,
mm-hmm.
knowing that you can leave anytime, the option is to walk out the door versus... If you come together with a contract, it's so much harder to break that contract. You're thinking twice. You want to work hard. You want to do all you got to do. You know, if you're just living together, there's really nothing to work for.
you feel like that? The love, the bond. You know what I mean? That's not for me. That's something natural to work on. You know what I mean? It's like the contract. Love shouldn't be work. It shouldn't be like... You shouldn't be working hard to, like, impress or, like... It should be something that you love doing because you love that person. You know what I mean?
And, you know, I agree with you to a certain extent. Because after your first fight, right? After that first year of marriage,
mm-hmm.
you have to make a decision to continue loving that person.
Yeah, regardless. And even if you got married or not, though.
Yeah, you know? But you have more... There's just that covenant. It's a covenant agreement. That's what it is.
Mm.
When you're in covenant with somebody, you don't want to walk away. Because it's a covenant agreement.
Okay.
That's what marriage is. It's a covenant agreement.
Okay, Blonde Locks. Putting us on a game. Guys, make sure... on the game. Make sure you guys go follow her, subscribe to her channel. Thank you for this lesson. You know, I'm definitely gonna take you with me for sure.
Anytime.
This is why I like doing these videos. You know, I could always, 10 years from now, I could sit back and watch this video and take some advice, you know. That's why I love it. I still watch the old video we did on meditation.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I still watch it a lot.
You know, I still meditate every single morning at 4:30.
Oh, nice.
That's the first thing I do.
Nice. And what one thing you said that stuck to me with that video was that you don't allow people to control your day. You know what I mean? That was one thing I took, you know, because I was allowing, like, my emotions with people to control me. If you got me mad this morning, it will control my day. You know what I mean? So that stuck to me. Like, I need to figure out how to not let that happen. So quick, just before we go, how would you, let's say somebody did something that got you upset this morning, how would you deter that from like stressing you out for the day.
Oh, I don't allow it to get in. You see this? It bounces right off.
Mm-hmm.
You have to be careful what you put in.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that's why I start out my morning at 4:30 with meditation. I read the Bible and I pray and then I work out.
Mm-hmm.
That's how I start my day. If you don't do that, if you don't command your morning, your day is going to command you.
That makes sense.
You got to tell the universe, you got to tell the world, or you know, your surroundings, what you want for the day. Today I'm going to be happy. Today every phone call that I make, I'm going to be successful at it. I'm not going to allow anybody to get me angry. I'm going to stay happy and I'm going to keep a smile on my face no matter what. This is my day. I command this day. You can't allow anybody to treat you like a puppet.
Yeah.
You know, they get you angry, and then, you know, for the rest of the day, they're controlling you. You're their puppet. No, what kind of sense does that make?
Yeah.
No, they're owning real estate in your head.
Yeah.
No, you got to kick them out. What do you do with real estate? You pay rent. They're paying you rent.
Yo. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Guys, make sure you guys subscribe to the channel. She's going to be posting more. Check her out on TikTok and YouTube. And this is your brand, right?
I'm dropping it
soon,
guys.
Damn. Okay.
I'm dropping it soon. Watch out for it. By June, it'll be on my page, TikTok and Instagram.
Yo, guys, go support her. She got the dopest women brand. Y'all see it? Get your body looking right and tight in those fits. You feel me? It don't matter what age. So go support. Support black businesses. Like I said, I always say, if you support, she's a family. So if you support her, you support me. We all got to grow. So check out her brand. Check out her TikTok, Instagram. Let's get it. We out, guys. Yeah.